cruise news time. Well, a big old pile of cruise news today. A cruise ship. Well, a cruise ship was in an accident. We got naming ceremonies. We got new cruise ships. We've got something that used to cost money that is now free. And well, we got bad news for Texas cruisers. Cruise news and my views. Let's talk about it. Hey, what's up, everybody? Welcome to La Lido Loca. I'm your host, Tony, here with the latest cruise news and views for your face for December the 12th, 2022. And well, let's go. Cruise news story number one, Aida Bella cruise ship cruising in Europe. Well, it done ran into a dock in Hamburg, Germany. And well, they cited the reason as a technical glitch. They done got glitched out. This ship had a lot of plans. It was finishing up a 26-day voyage. Then it was supposed to go on a 42-day voyage. Well, now they got to fix the glitch. More details to come. But this thing's busted up, cracked up, dented a little bit. And, now we'll have to wait and see what happens. Things that go bump when you're trying to dock. How about that? Cruise news story number two. We've got a couple cruise ships that had their naming ceremony. Going to tell you all about it. But first, I'd like to thank the sponsor of today's show, Skillshare.
Today's episode is sponsored by Skillshare. Skillshare, an online learning community for lifelong learners, for the curious, for professionals, for dabblers, for anyone who is inquisitive. There is an opportunity at Skillshare for you to learn something new. I like Skillshare because it's a place that I can go and learn new things pretty much uninterrupted, without ads, without distractions. The thing I've been experimenting with toward the end of 2022 is challenging maybe my own strengths. I feel like I'm pretty confident on camera. And so, well, I said, let me watch a video about being confident on camera. I've been working through this course by Nathaniel Drew about that very thing, how to be more confident on camera. Why Skillshare? Why right now? Well, it's the end of the year. It's a good time to start something new. And well, instead of buying something for yourself or something for someone else to just clutter up their house or just to be more stuff, why not give the gift of knowledge? Why not give the gift of learning? Of course, you can get it at a discount. Skillshare has a great offer for the Loca fam. The first 1,000 people to click the link in the description below will get a 1-month free trial of Skillshare. Hit that link, learn something new. Thank you so much, Skillshare, for sponsoring today's episode.
Well, over the past week, we had a couple really big naming ceremonies. The first one was for the MSC Seascape up there in New York City. MSC Seascape is MSC's newest cruise ship. Highlights of the ceremony included a performance by Matteo Bocelli. Sophia Loren, the godmother of this cruise ship, did the blessing virtually. It's going to be an interesting cruise ship. Another cruise ship MSC has put forward to try to make waves in the North American market. And like I said before, they even put a ride on top, like a carnival ride called the Robotron. MSC Seascape, I cannot wait to try this sometime in the near future. We've had this conversation. Are you an MSC fan? Will you never try it? Leave a comment below. And well, that wasn't the only cruise ship that got named in the last week. Just a couple days ago, Friday, as it were, the world's largest cruise ship, the Wonder of the Seas, well, she had her naming ceremony. And you may be saying, but what? That ship came out in March of 2022. Yes, that cruise ship has sailed with over 180,000 passengers. It has been sailing for 9 months, unnamed. I mean, it was named, we knew what it was called, but it did not have the official naming ceremony. The naming ceremony was delayed until the Wonder of the Seas was officially ported in her official home port, Port Canaveral. And of course, just like every other naming ceremony, lots of fanfare. They did something interesting to come up with the godmother for the Wonder of the Seas. They put out a TikTok challenge and they wanted people to nominate moms, the Wonder Moms, to be the godmother of the Wonder of the Seas. And so a wonderful woman was chosen and she was there at the naming ceremony to do the naming and the blessing. And they also highlighted other finalists in that TikTok challenge. So how about that? Social media has begat a godmother for a cruise ship. And then another interesting thing that Royal Caribbean does with all of their namings is they play bagpipe music. The naming ceremony did feature the Mount Dora Bagpipe Band. How about that? You could get them to play at your next wedding. I don't know if that's true or not. Would you like to have a bagpipe wedding band? And again, this thing's filled with all kinds of interesting tidbits. They had a specially made champagne bottle to smash into the Wonder of the Seas, and it was the equivalent It was the equivalent of 12 regular champagne bottles. Wonder of the Seas, finally named, finally home ported in Port Canaveral, Florida. And interesting ship. I hope you got to check out both the ship tour and the suite tour I did of the Wonder of the Seas. It really is a fantastic piece of hardware to behold. Make sure you check those out. Cruise news story number 4, Viking has taken ownership of its next cruise ship. This one's called the Viking Neptune. And well, much like in the Grease movie, this ship is hydromatic. It's systematic and it's hydromatic. Why this ship is, well, it's Viking Neptune. It has a hydrogen fuel system. That's what I'm trying to say. It's a new cleaner burning technology. The hydrogen fuel system, efficiency. Will this become the standard? It's interesting when innovation happens in the industry, you've got to wonder what's going to be the standards. LNG going to be the standard? Hydrogen going to be the standard? Is old diesel fuel going to be the standard? You know, it's like that Sony Betamax versus VHS conversation, which is kind of moot at this point since everything is, well, moved to, you know, DVDs and now it's streaming. But yeah, do you remember the old VHS Betamax? Did you have a Betamax? Do you feel stupid? Don't feel stupid. I know a lot of people that had Betamaxes and a Laserdisc. That's a whole nother conversation. But yes, the Viking Neptune Hydromatic. This cruise ship has 465 staterooms holding 930 passengers. It's 47,800 tons. Now, the Viking Neptune is going to spend its initial sailing season, its inaugural season, in the Mediterranean. And eventually, this is going to become a world cruise ship, doing a world cruise from Fort Lauderdale to London, spanning 138 days, 57 ports, 28 countries, and it will involve overnight stays in 11 cities. It seems like there's a quicker way to get from Fort Lauderdale to London, but why not do it on a cruise ship? Any Viking fans out there, please sound off in the comments. Just say, yay, I like Viking. How about that? Leave a comment below. Now, I got two really important things to tell you. I got to tell you about the 4-pay service that Royal Caribbean is now making for free coming up in 2023. And, well, we got bad news for Texas cruisers. But before I get there, let me quickly invite you to subscribe. If you like staying up to date with everything that's going on in cruising, please consider subscribing with the notification bell on. That way you don't miss out on any of these episodes. We're trying to get to 250,000 subscribers by the end of the year. We only have about 15 more days to go. We're a little bit behind the eight ball, but you could do your part by hitting the subscribe button. If we got to 250,000 subscribers by the end of the year, it would be a bona fide Christmas miracle. So be a miracle maker. That's what I'm saying today. Hit the subscribe button, notification bell. That way you don't miss out on any of the shows. Royal Caribbean, Carnival Cruise Line, and others, they have an app that you put on your phone, and that's how they're doing a lot of stuff on the cruise ship these days. And one of the features that people sometimes like, sometimes don't like, is the ability to chat with other cruisers on their cruise inside that application. Now, Carnival has a pretty easy scenario for chatting, that you pay $5 for the entire cruise per person, and you can chat with other people that are on the cruise. Royal Caribbean does it a little bit differently. They charge you $1.99 per day per person, and then you can chat with anybody on the cruise. Well, Royal Caribbean has recognized that that chat feature is so important that it should be free. Excitingly, in that Wonder of the Sea sailing where the naming ceremony happened, CEO Michael Bailey, talking to travel advisors, came out and said, look, it's an important service. We're going to make it free next year. This comes kind of on the heels of the big announcement that all of the Royal Caribbean fleet is going to Starlink, which should provide a better internet service. Of course, the chat, I think the chat's probably hosted in the ship. I would love to see the technology. So I don't know if you guys know how, you know, I'm sure you know how the internet works, but if you're going to like go to a web page from a cruise ship, it has to leave the cruise ship and go to a satellite and go to a server somewhere where the website is, and then it makes that trip back through the satellite. I would assume that the chat service, since it's primarily on the cruise ship, maybe there's a server here on the cruise ship where it all stays on the cruise ship. Again, I don't know what their infrastructure is like. It seems like if I was designing that, if I could put a server on board just to host the chat, I would do that. But I don't know. Does anybody have any insight to how the chat works? But beyond that, if you do not and you're a Royal Caribbean cruiser, are you Tress excited that you will now be able to chat for free? Normally doesn't bother us because we purchased the internet package, but this will really benefit people who do not purchase the internet package, who want to only chat on the cruise ship. How about them apples? How about it? Yeah, it's pretty cool. Way to go, Royal Caribbean International. Now, I'm sorry, you little, you know, cowgirls and buckaroos, but we got some bad news for cruisers in Texas. Yes, did you hear? Over the last couple days, word came out that the Carnival Jubilee that was set to be homeported in Galveston, Texas, is going to be delayed. That's right, they're still trying to round up some calves that got loose up in the upper 40, and well, they're not going to get them back home in time to bring the Jubilee to Galveston, Texas. I don't know, been watching too much Yellowstone. Jenny calls me Rip and asks me to wear a cowboy hat. I don't know what that's all about, but only she knows. Carnival notified its passengers in a press release that the ship would be delayed because of, well, delays from the shipbuilder. The initial transatlantic cruise and the initial voyages from Galveston, Texas, they've been canceled. This equals about 6 cruises, and now the Jubilee will debut in Galveston on December the 23rd, 2023. I know a lot of people had those early cruises booked. Were you booked? Did you get cancellated? If so, we commiserate with you. Leave a comment below. And I gotta tell you something that's ironic. We started to go to the comedy show last night, but it's the same comedian that pulled me up on stage to do improv when I was on the Island Princess. One of the most fantastical and nerve-wracking experiences of my life. If you've never seen me attempt improv and you want to go make fun of me, check out this video next. This is Tony for La Lido Loca, and until the next time, we'll see you on the Lido. Bye.